Hello, everybody. This is the Rad Man, and we are here for some more Farming Simulator 2017. So if you'll notice, I still have the rake from before because I spent about half an hour figuring out the right ratio and stuff to go versus speed with this. To not overwhelm the wrapper. And then I went and saved the game about a second before I remembered that we had bought this and to see if it would fit on the back of this. It's actually worked better though to have a smaller rake, because that bigger rake, like especially if I'm trying to go up and down like this, that bigger rake would sometimes hit into me, and that would cause, you know, a few problems. And I discovered that problem that I was having with the square baler, it can happen to any tractor when you load a save, especially like if they're already in formation. Sometimes the very first one that needs to hook to the first tractor, sometimes you need to drive that one away, like, I don't know how many meters away, but it seems to kind of reset it if you drive it far enough away and then drive it back. But yeah, so this is basically what our little parade looks like when it's running. And I really like that crone. And I did discover that if you pause at the right times, you can actually, you know, not have as much trouble as I've been having with that bale wrapper, because what I'll do is I'll do quite a bit of the hay and then I'll have the rake paused. I'll unpause the rake to let it catch up, and then I'll pause this guy while I'm waiting for this guy, and yeah, that way it still gets done. It does take a little bit longer, and I do have to switch between vehicles, but you know, I was already having to do that anyway just to check on stuff. But yeah. I think what we're going to do this episode is we actually need to check. I've been kind of neglecting our animals. You can see stuff starting to go down. I don't really care about the cleanliness because I still haven't seen it affect the productivity at all. Let's speed up time though, because we don't actually have any hay that we can, you know, do right now. And I'd like to test it out on these fields up here. One thing I did consider doing, though, was buying a new silo. The problem is that these are pretty stinking expensive. The problem is, though, is that if we don't buy one of those, we're kind of also in trouble. I'm really thinking this would be a good thing to get. Obviously, we do have, you know, that container. What I kind of want to test, though, actually, you know what? Let's actually slow down time. And I just figured we'll save the game because I know that I want everything in that line. So we're going to save the game, and then we're going to, you know, go over to the sheep or the cows. I don't know why on earth I said sheep, farm to cows. Okie dokie, that should be... Oh, that was not in the right mode. There we go. But yeah, because what I want to try doing is seeing if we place down the feed station, if we can actually dump it straight into the mixing tub. And I think most people call it a tub grinder. I either say feeder, mixer, or anything that my brain just randomly comes up with. But yeah, we'll try putting it, we'll try putting the mix from the mesh station directly in, because that way we wouldn't have to keep a loader down there as often, except to clean it, because mesh station, I believe each section of it can hold like half a stack, like over a stack of bales from the auto stacker, and that's the big 16 bale auto stacker, so it should hold more than enough finished product. I still haven't had to mess with this grass at all. I'm assuming it's just gonna take it when it needs it. Actually, let's try something. Because it seems to me like with these bales, if they aren't updated when you reload the game, they don't get taken. Yeah, see, because once I updated them by hitting it, it took one of them. So all we'll have to do is nudge one of those once our little bar starts going down, and we'll be good. And let's also see how this guy's doing. So the water's still good. The manure's at about 50%. We'll probably top it off while we're here. But let's buy the Mish station now, because I kind of like that they made it so that where you're placing something is based on what tractor you're in. At the same time, though, it does make it a little bit awkward if you want to place something like up on a hill or something. How big is this Mish station? Come on. Holy cow, this is either really big or it's glitched out, because I don't see it. Let's actually go over to our farm and spawn it in on our land. We won't buy it, obviously, but I want to see just how big this thing is. I hope this isn't glitched, because it's acting glitched. Because it's not even not appearing at all. Oh, what a bummer. I guess it was too good to be true. The mod did come out within days of, the game coming out, which should have been a little bit of a warning flag, though I would have thought it wouldn't have worked, or at least that Maru would have tested it. Then again, I think it did say, though, that the person who, that it wasn't Maru who ported it over. Yeah, this is weird. I don't even think we're in buying mode, because I just noticed it doesn't have the rotate buttons, so... Yeah, I don't think you can actually buy that. I'll have to see if there's an update out for that mod. Or if there's, another version of it that works. So I guess we'll just clean up. Yeah, I was really hoping we could test that, but... Well, things happen, I guess. But while we're down here, I guess we can, fill up the manure. Yeah, that kind of killed my joy, because I was gonna see if that would work, because that would mean that we wouldn't have to have, as much equipment down here to run this. Though I will say that once I did get everything topped off with those, I think I used 2 loads of that feed. It's actually been pretty slow about using it otherwise. So let's dump this back in here, just because I don't want manure sitting around everywhere. Let's go hook onto the water and refill that. The funny thing is, I haven't even had a full day with this thing yet, so it looks like every day you need to come tend them, at least the manure part of them. The water's been okay. It's just the manure that needs tending. How bad's their straw? Okay, their straw's good enough. We don't need to worry about it. So I think all we should need to do is we'll just clean up some of this. I'm not going to be real picky about it. There we go. And then we can unhook that. I'm considering buying the bigger loader that can go on this, just for the simple fact that occasionally that does get stuck on the frame of the tractor. But it seems to be when I unhook it a certain way, so let's see. So we want cows to farm. Good. We'll get this guy going home. I was going to say we could try buying the loader, but I don't really want to spend money on it if it'll work to not have it. This guy'll stop him when he gets back, so we're good now. Let's speed up time, because that did kind of kill what I was wanting to do this episode. Let's see. Okay, those guys have still got a while to go. Now I'll have to try and clean this without hitting that bale for a while. Oh, I missed again. There we go. Let's see. So, ooh, the wool's almost done. Let's see if we can tell what happens when the wool finishes up. Because it should take quite a while for that stuff to grow up there. I guess we may as well save the game since we didn't actually buy anything. That was a bummer, but you know, it's like some mods, especially the usually high quality mods like Maru mods, if those come out in the first one or two days, you gotta be a little suspicious anyways. Let's just move this guy over just because I want to be able to tell when the grass gets grown. And there's our cow. Oh. I thought I was over this stupid cold, but obviously I'm not. We'll stop this guy just so that message will go away. Okie dokie. These guys are good. I was going to say, it would be so cheaty if you could get in and harvest the grass that those guys are eating. Just because it's like, probably not supposed to be able to get in there. Okie dokie. So that also makes me wonder, if 1887 is 94% of the wool, it must be like 2500 or something, because I'm pretty sure that 108 more shouldn't be, yeah, it wouldn't be another 5%. And I also wonder if the cows are making more milk, because it seems to me like I made more milk, I think it was yesterday than the day before. Then again, that might have been just because, you know, they had a full day of production and the day before they didn't. So let's actually check it when it gets dark. Yeah, that's not going to be ready for at least another few hours. So let's run back over here and see what happens. Just trying to watch, because I want to see if it spawns in a new one of these, but at the same time, I don't want to miss those statistics. Oh yeah, this is probably more like, I'm going to say at least 2,100. But it might only be 2,000. I haven't done very complex math in a while. Plus I've, you know, actually that's 96. That could actually be just 2,000. Let's get on the roof because I like being on the roof. There we go. Oop! I say there we go, and I haven't even got up there yet. There we go. Haha. Okay, phone, what do you want? Okay, I don't really care. Okay. Yeah, I get a bunch of text promotions from a restaurant in the area. And it's like every 5 minutes, here's another promotion. I'm like, okay. I appreciate the promotions. I don't appreciate them, you know, in the middle of most of the time, actually. Unless I'm going out to eat. Okay, so we made 3,000. So I think we are making the same amount from milk each day. That was more property income. So I think that we make $1,000 a day off of that one beehive. Actually, it should be 1,400. Greenhouse, not beehive. I don't know what I was saying. And I forgot to look at our costs. Let's actually see. So we put 207 on that. Okay, this one must not have gotten repaired for a while, because it shouldn't have gotten $900 worth of damage in one sitting. These ones, I could see them getting that much on them, though, because they just sat there for quite a while. Let's speed back up, though, and get back here, and we should be 97. We only have 50 more. And yeah. That really bums me out about that Maru station, because, like, I didn't actually, like, it was kind of funny, because when I got it for 2015, I didn't actually think it would be that good of a thing. Holy cow, let me tell you, I loved it by the time that I actually, you know, figured out every little detail about how it worked, because some of the prompts, like, on how to control it are always broken, for me at least. But once I figured out like how to move the spout and stuff, and I got it in a good position, it was so easy because you just stick in like 20 bales, let it process it for a harvest, and then you wouldn't have to mess around with feeding the cows very much because you just put it in a trailer and tip it into them. Of course, now you would have to, you know, go and clean up after them. But that's still, I really like that Mish station. I don't know if it's actually, I don't know how you're supposed to say any of these things, if you can't tell already, but yeah, I will butcher the names of them. Let's see, so we are at 99%. It should be one more cycle, and then we should see, so 1994, let's save it at this. And yeah, I do think that the cow's cleanliness goes down faster than the sheep's. Because we did clean them at around the same time. And I didn't even clean the sheep all the way. And they're better than the cows. Which is ironic because the cows have a lot larger of an area. Okay. So we are at 2,100%. Is it going to spawn in another pallet? So I think it's like every 15 minutes is when it updates. So, okay. Okay, it does. So you can hold, like, let's see. This is probably space for at least, like, six pallets. So that is pretty cool. Now the only problem with it is that I have to wait for this one to fill up to get to this one. Because I don't think that my skid loader is going to fit right here to grab this out. And I did also download a mod. There was one called, like, Advanced Processing Kit or something. I'm not sure if that's actually doing anything. And I did find a mod that's supposed to make it easier to feed bales, but I haven't noticed it doing anything, so I'll probably uninstall it after this recording session. Who knows? It could be something causing trouble in the background, actually. Wouldn't be surprising. I've had mods do really weird things before when I've had them just open in the background. But yeah, I guess one thing I should have tested when I bought this that I forgot to is, does it cut plants? Because I know that some of the older versions of this, especially if this was just ported over from 2015, those would cut the plants usually, and it doesn't, which is great. So we'll turn that off, fold this up, and then off camera, I'll do another harvest. The nice thing is, though, is that now that I actually know how this mod works, the Follow Me mod, you know, I can actually keep stuff running. Like, before it was like every 5 seconds I'd be down because of something I hadn't realized. But now we'll be good. One thing I did forget to mention is I do need to buy more pallets, and I'm going to go buy them. But I'm not going to show it on camera because I've showed it on camera, I think, at least twice already. So, yeah, I'm going to go make more money, and then we might look at and see about buying either a new tractor or getting into the corn business. We actually might have enough to get into the corn business, I just realized, because I was like, what could I fill my silos with now? Because my silos are going to be full after this next harvest of almost everything. Let's see, we need 250, I believe. So we could use one of these, which is the same size as our cedar, for 32,000. We could get a corn planting machine. You're a corn planting machine, right? Yes, you are. We could get this guy for 60,000. So that would be 90,000 right there. How much is a header for our combine? The header is 34,000, so we don't quite have enough. But I think what I'll do is I'll do one of these harvests off camera with, you know, the Follow Me, and then using that money we'll see about getting corn after this canola. So yeah, I shall be right back. Hello everyone, I am back. I just barely finished doing the grass over there, and this grass has actually grown back, so I'll probably harvest this part of it and over by where the combine is, but I'm probably not going to do the really hilly part again because I almost lost a few bales into the lake over there, and that was annoying. But I also might not, depending on how much money we spend right now. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to buy this corn header, because we can use it as a sunflower header. We'll just be slower, so we're going to buy it. Good. And then we also need a cultivator, because we need this guy. 180 horsepower. And we will have enough to buy the seed, it looks like, for this guy, right? Yes, good. Buy this guy. That's interesting that this one can also plant soybeans and sugar beets as well as that other stuff. Yeah, that's quite interesting the way that it does it. Oh, and then we also need more pallets. That's what I was going to buy off camera, but I decided to buy on camera instead. We'll buy 3 of these at least, if not 4 or 5. We'll buy 4, why not? And then we'll buy, let's see, these guys, which we'll buy 2 of them because they're quite expensive. Now I'll take this guy down to the cows, and I'll pick up, I think I left my pallet fork down there. No, my pallet fork's actually up here. So I think what we're going to do is save the game, because I know that I want what I have now, and then I'm also going to buy this front loader, which it says 700 vario, but I'm hoping that just means it's for anything bigger than the 700 vario. So we'll try that. I can always bring the bale spike from the cows if I need to, but since I will have to make a few trips back and forth, let's see, farm to shop, since I will have to make a few trips back and forth, you know, With the implements, we'll also have the case go over there. Good. Yeah, we'll have the case run over there too. That way we can get, you know, it won't take too many trips. And yeah, I still have everything in order for mowing. But, holy cow, I really probably should have set it to go, at the speed I recorded it at, because that was pretty crazy. But yeah, what I was gonna say was, since everything's still in order, that's really the only reason I'm debating doing more silage, because it does go faster. I have found, though, that if you spend more than, I think it's about half an hour with all the vehicles in a group, sometimes if you, take one vehicle out and then try to add it back in, like, for instance, I took the baler and I was going to take it and the bale wrapper and get some of the baling that had been done, because I accidentally did Control F instead of Control H, because I sometimes have to pause the baler so it can catch up on stuff. Mainly it's because of the bale wrapper, but I don't want the baler to get too ahead either. But yeah, there's just a few little issues like that. So we're going to leave that there, that way it's in the way. And we'll see if this guy fits. It looks like it actually might be too tall, but it does fit. So this means that we now have 2 loaders. I'm not going to sell the smaller one, because the smaller one can still be used on the case, and I think the smaller one has to be used on the case. I did overlook the little fact that we're going to have to get... that unfolds, yeah, okay. We may as well actually fill this up while we're here. I did overlook the fact that we're going to have to bring the combine down to pick this up. So that's fun. We'll stop this guy. And, yeah, then we'll send these two home. So we need shop to farm, which is at the bottom of the list. A little too far. Good. And, yeah, then we'll send these two home, and we'll have to cultivate it with this and then plant it with that, which is fine. You know, it'll take a little bit longer, but I think where it's a relatively big cultivator, it shouldn't be too much more noticeable. The cedar is actually what's going to be the slowest thing now. And that cedar does not hold a lot. That only holds 560. Our one that we use now uses, let's see, I think the one that we use now holds like 3,600 or 4,000 almost. I know it holds a lot. That's one of the main reason I got the Pallet X mod, is so that I could fit all those extra pallets that we were using. But I'd have to, you know, I'd have to bring home like 4 pallets, and then I'd use them all instantaneously. I also remembered I still need to get that stupid pallet that's been sitting by the side of the road since it fell off my low loader before we bought the bale trailer. I always forget to, though. And let's actually see. So this guy, I didn't read its exact meters, but it looks like it is a 8-row... Yeah, 2, 4, 6, 8. So this is a little 8-row corn planter. I don't dare see if those are actual physical objects, because I don't want to clothesline it off those. But yeah, so we'll make sure it's on... actually, we could do sunflowers. Which one is sells for more, actually? Let's see. So between the two... we probably want sunflowers, then corn. We should only have to do one or two harvests of sunflowers, though I don't know their yield, so I'll have to keep that in mind, is that I do not know the yield of them. And yeah, this guy can stay down here now. He's done. Since we have to actually record a combine course to send the combine up there, because even though we aren't sending it up there with a header on it, we will need a course, so if we do send them back to the shop with their headers to sell them, because I was able to just use the, farm to shop course to sell that other combine, the littler one. Now we send this guy back to the shop. A lot of running back and forth this episode. But yeah, overall I am satisfied with how that mod works. But like I said, there are a few very minor nitpicks. We need to unhook that. If I could suggest one thing to the guy who makes Follow Me, I would say it's a good mod. Maybe work on having it not freak out, like when you reload the save and stuff, because... reloading saves either helps it or hurts it, like, a lot. It either helps it a lot by fixing some internal issue, or it hurts it a lot by making it, so that, it can't recognize. Like, I had to reload the save twice to get it to recognize my mower last time. But I've got it to recognize it since, so we should be good if I do decide to do the mowing. We'll just leave... Oh my gosh, I hate how it auto-sets the cruise control to be field work. Because this guy can actually go decently fast, it's just that... if you don't pay attention to the cruise control, you can spend forever on this road. But yeah, like I said, we're gonna record it in the middle of here, because... I think there's only two or three headers in the game that are like the wheat headers that actually fold up enough to go down the road, and they don't actually fold up, they just sit on a trailer. And I know that there are header trailers in the game, But I can never get them to work. I usually end up either the header falls off once I put it on, and then the combine ends up shooting into space once I, you know, get it working again. Or the other thing that happens when I try and, you know, deal with those header trailers is that it just falls off whenever I go over a bump in the field. It's like, so there's no tie-down straps? It's kind of silly. Okay, stop, and that is combine farm to shop. It's actually more specifically middle of road to shop, but close enough. Okay, we'll leave him there because he'll just cause trouble. Oh, and I did find out that if you leave those guys running, they'll just hit that power pole over there. That's all that happens to them. And, you know, that's not that big of a deal compared to some other things that Courseplay's done when I'm not watching. But it is, you know, it is pretty annoying, at least. So we'll just get this guy. Oh, he was in fieldwork mode. No wonder I forgot to stick him in that mode. There we go. Now he's actually booking it. Bye. That's still relatively slow, but now we can actually load this trailer. And we will, this guy must have been really confused because I left both of those loaded at the same time. It's probably a good thing he couldn't get up here or he would have been back at the farm by now. Let's straighten this out. And I think it's the best with these pallets to not try squishing them together too much. Just because they are a little bit finicky, like, especially what happened when we first loaded them. Like, if you didn't see it, basically what happened was the pallet, I think it was a little too tall of fertilizer, decided that it was going to get stuck on some invisible hitbox up near the hitch. And I had to drive home with it like that, and I almost wrecked it in the pond. Then you have stuff like this where you can barely... it's barely not low enough, and then you end up scooting the pallet 20 feet over. And then they're also... at the same time, they're heavy enough that they do slide off relatively easily. But they're also so heavy that if they decide not to slide off easily, they can easily stay stuck on there for quite a while. Oops. I will say, though, that this loader, at least, you know, right now, seems like it's doing well. Oh, I just realized I forgot to put a waypoint on that new transfer course for the combine now that it gives me that waiting message. So that's going to be fun to deal with. The next time we send a combine up to the shop, it's going to be trying to turn around in the middle of the road. And holy cow, I do not know how that did not fall off. I'm trying to think about what to talk about while I'm doing this. Oh, one thing is that I don't know. I think I posted the video today, but I'm basically kind of renewing Assassin's Creed Syndicate. Like, I took a really long break from it, but now I'm going to be trying to record it alongside Farming Simulator and maybe Big Pharma. The problem with Big Pharma is that you can easily spend an hour deciding how to set up one production line. And, like, Factorio is very similar, but Factorio... you don't usually take an hour to set up the one production line because, you know, you can't easily pause it and think about it. Big Pharma, my problem is I always pause to think about everything, and holy cow, these things are, like, insanely heavy. Like, look at how heavy these things are. Like, I can't move them with my forks. That doesn't help that it's a fertilizer thing, though. This is kind of ridiculous. Like, look at that. This little box is entirely lifting my tractor. I can put the straps on it right there. I don't know how well it's gonna work. Is there really? Okay, I was gonna say, if there isn't a strap there, that's just stupid. Yeah, I think they need a few more straps on these. Get out of there. Thank you. Because I think we did a little bit of testing, and I'm pretty sure that though, these are, you can't walk on them. Or, I mean, you can walk on them, but I'm pretty sure that to, like, light posts and stuff, these are actually not here. I'm pretty sure it's just this one. But I guess we'll find out. Because I'll have to manually drive it home if that's actually there. Let's actually take it by this stop sign and see if we can get it to hit, like, the second or third one. That did knock it over. He might have updated the mod and added actual textures to those, because I know before they weren't much more than just a stand-in, just to give it the extra height. That could be fun. Okay, I guess let's load shop to farm and see if it'll get down there without killing someone. There we go. Good, it adjusted itself. Good. Okay, this guy's done. Yeah, I totally forgot the waypoint. I guess if I put the combine in fieldwork mode, it doesn't need a wait point. But most vehicles, especially if they have a trailer, don't work in fieldwork mode like a combine will. Let's actually see how big this header is. So it is a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I think that's an 8-row header. Yeah, it's an 8-row header. But we'll put it over here because we need to harvest... sorry. First time I've done that. This recording. Not this episode, this recording. But yeah, we need to harvest canola first. And there's our seeder, so we'll have the combine stop him. And I think that 16,000 is enough left over. Oh, please tell me he's gonna stop. But yeah, I think that 16,000 is enough left over that I am not going to doing more silage, because at this point I have so much in my grain tanks, I probably should be selling grain instead of making silage every 5 minutes. Because the main reason I even produce the grain is obviously for money. And I guess if you wanted to get technical about it, you could actually do, once you can afford the bale wrapper and a swather and the small round baler, I guess you technically wouldn't need to own anything more than one tractor that can run all three of those. It would be a pretty crappy way to run it, in my opinion, but I guess you could do that. That is fertilizer, and of course fertilizer is what we use up. We use up fertilizer at like half the rate that we use up seed, so that's great. We'll obviously have to move this out of the way, but for now, since we're not going to be using it, let's just park it over to the side of the road. Because I find that if I park these, like, somewhere out of the way of all the stuff, it's kind of funny, because if they're actually out of the way enough that they won't be in my way, I forget where I put them. So it's kind of counterintuitive to put them in the way, but that way I at least know where they are. Oh yeah, I was going to say, when Watch Dogs 2 comes out for the PC, I'm going to wait for the reviews to come out for it on the PC, but if they're good reviews, like, I was going to play Watch Dogs a while ago, but since the reviews for the PC said it was basically a terrible port, I decided not to. But yeah, there might be Watch Dogs 2 in our future, if of course they made a good PC port this time. And if they didn't, then I guess we won't play it, because I don't have a PlayStation 4, and with Steam as an option, I really don't see the reason to use consoles anymore, because they're just... They're basically a new graphics card to for the computer is basically the price that they run at. And yeah, and then it's like $60 for a new game when I can get like a $20 pretty good early access game on Steam that's like more thought out than a AAA game. I've seen a few of those. But yeah, anyway, I'm going to finish up doing this. There we go. And yeah, do not you dare. Do not. Good. I'm gonna probably speed up time because, like I said, we don't need more money. And I'd kind of want a great demand. And even with this nice mower, we do need to get like a square bale wrapper or something, because the ideal thing would be to have bales that didn't move when they come out of the baler, and then you would just have the swather through the baler go first, and then you wouldn't get too far ahead, because if you get too far ahead in the course, the follow me does forget where it's going. So that is something just to warn you if you're doing a big course. But basically what you need to do to fix that is if you do Control H, it'll wait until you tell it to stop waiting. So if you had a bale wrapper that would wrap bales that don't move, like square bales, you could just have the wrapper come along afterwards, once all the big equipment's out of the way, and then you would just watch it wrap. You just basically make sure it didn't go too fast. But yeah, anyway, I'll be right back. I'll probably be back after this is all planted, and maybe even after it's regrown, depending on how much money we have left. That'll decide whether or not I do silage. And who knows, maybe since we can use Follow Me, I'll just do all the silage in one this time. But yeah, I'll be right back. Hey guys, I'm back. So I just wanted to show you something really cool about our little planter real quick. It actually holds fertilizer, but for some reason it didn't let me fill it with fertilizer till I went to hire a worker. And then it realized that it needed that. Holy cow, why does that need 13 already? I haven't even used it at all. Let's see though, it should be hireable now, and it should also be. Well, that's weird. It said it should be fertilizing, I think. That is really weird. Because. Yeah, look at that. It has a grain tank, it has a tank, two tank capacities. So I don't know why it's got two separate tank capacities. I don't actually know. I thought that was a fertilizer tank, but whatever it is, that one has it too. And I don't know why. I don't know if it's something that Courseplay was always supposed to do, but now whenever this combine gets done, it calls over this guy, so that's somewhat useful, somewhat annoying if you only have a little bit of grain in the tank. But it does mean that you can always send him home when you get done. There we go. So yeah, I'm gonna finish up the rest of this harvest. I should probably get that cultivator going again. I had to stop him for a minute, but yeah, I'll have to pay attention, 'cause I'm not sure. I know it did fill with fertilizer, but the ground does not look fertilized from that. So I'm not exactly sure what on earth is going on. Might have to do a little bit of research on that. Looks like that guy's stuck. I really need to just re-record that course, the little grain guy's running, 'cause he always hits into this, and it's really annoying. I really shouldn't have put it this close to the power lines. Those are railroad tracks. Holy cow. But yeah. I'll be right back after we get done. I I'll have to see what happens if I try. Actually, I know, we can look at the map and see if it's actually fertilized or not. Let's see, so we've got cultivated to growing to harvested all in the same field. And we've got, so it is fertilizing it, I just can't see it, so that's really interesting. And it is doing it all the way fertilized. Interesting, except it stopped. That might be because the map might not have updated or something. Once it gets done with this entire field, we'll look and see if the entire thing says fertilized, because that's quite interesting. You can also see the fields that I took the time to fix the ends and some of them that I didn't. But yeah, guys, anyway, I can't remember how much time we have left. I think we're getting down within the last, like, 20 minutes of the episode. So I'll be right back after this harvest, and then we'll probably either sell some grain, or I might show you guys the best distances that I have found out to run all the follow me stuff at, because that's a really cool mod. Like, I am surprised. I didn't think I would, you know, use it that much. I've been using it a lot. And this is just within 2 days of finding it. But yeah, anyway, guys, I'll be right back. Hello, everybody. I am back. What we're going to be doing now is, once this helper gets done, we're going to refuel this tractor and repair it. And then I'm going to speed up time so that all the grass regrows. And I haven't cut the grass over there, so we're going to see how much damage we put on to the vehicles if we use follow me to do like 3 or 4 or 5 things in a row. Before we do that, though, I am going to save it afterwards. And I'm just going to really quickly look for another, see if there's that bale mod yet, because that bale wrapper mod, I should say, not a bale mod, but a bale wrapper mod, because that bale wrapper would be really useful. But if we can't find it, we'll just do it with the round baler. Yeah, it's just that the round bales, they are so much fun to deal with. Let's see if we can get this. I kind of want to use up this stuff on the ground, so we'll use up that little bit of fertilizer. Then we have to get this over by the seed to refill the seed. And we'll just park this over to the side since it's nice and compact. And yeah, we'll use it again next time. Except we'll use it to plant... really, it can't refill in the front. Except we will use it to, there we go. Next time we'll use it to plant, corn, because this time we planted sunflowers. We might see how much corn or sunflowers we get, though that would require harvesting almost everything before planting anything, so we probably won't wait. I don't know, I haven't really decided. Let's actually check how much fuel this little thing has left in it. It holds a lot. The only thing I haven't refueled from it is that guy over there, because I believe it holds quite a bit. Yeah, we still have 40% left in that little trailer. So I guess let's switch around our vehicle list again. It should be mostly intact. Just gotta switch that. And I think we go one. Okay, this guy needs to be behind these two. And then it needs to be this guy before him. There we go. Good. Okay. This guy holds 1,200 liters. We have 1,271 in it now. I'm, not sure how many it actually holds, but we can pretty easily find out. So it holds, I'm guessing it's more than 1,300. Is it 1,300? 1400, I'm guessing. Oh, 1390. Okay, that's a really interesting number. But yeah, so I'm going to save the game, and then I'm going to start from in here. And the episode might go a little short because of this, but I'm going to do all of this off camera, since I haven't showed exactly how you set it up on camera, but the basic idea is you just line it up, and then you start the one that follows the mower, then you start the baler, and the mower and baler can usually be left at the default setting. Actually, the mower needs to be at 15. The baler can be at 10 or 15. And then... No, wait. Yeah, 15 or 20 is what I meant. And then the bell wrapper, I usually leave at 10. I might try turning it down to 5, though, to see if it'll quit missing bales, because I've been having a problem where if it bales on, like, on a slope, then the bale will barely miss the entrance of this, because the problem is 2 meters over isn't quite enough to get it past that big wheel. 2.5 meters is almost having it be too much. But yeah, I'm going to save the game, and then I'm going to restart it, and I'll show you guys how much damage we put on this fleet. The only thing I do have to remember is to repair the auto stacker before I use it. I think it's sitting, yeah, it's sitting over here. So let's actually see. I've never repaired this auto stacker before that I can remember. How much? Oh, we haven't. I probably have repaired it then, because I'm pretty sure that I put more time on it than that. How much have we put on this one? Yeah, I was going to say 145 is way too low. I must have repaired it without remembering. Anyway, though, I'll be right back. Let's actually check the cows real quick. I haven't checked them for a while. Okay, so the cows are at 0% cleanliness, and their productivity is actually going down. I'm guessing that's a slow decline. We should probably... I'm going to get this guy headed over there after he cleans up the sheep, though. And that way we'll just know that it's good, because I would rather not have problems with my cows. Anyway, so... just leave that there. So yeah, let's see, sheep to cows, there we go. Anyway, guys, I'll be right back.